Hello, everybody. Actually, my name is Eric Aquino Ortiz. I am a PhD student in the Astronomy Institute at UNAI, Mexico City. So together with my collaborators, we want to explore the maximum velocities of galaxies using the MANGA survey. The motivation is that in the Lambda CDM cosmological model, there are very robust predictions, for example, the halo mass function for different redshift ranges, which can be translated to the maximum velocity function also for different redshift ranges. This velocity function is quite sensitive to the interaction between the dark matter and the baryonic dynamics. So there are several works using observational data to explore the velocity function. One example is Becquerite 2016 using 226 Khalifa galaxies. In this plot, you can see the results in green symbols. The white region is where Khalifa is complete, where the Khalifa sample is complete. And also, they compare with H1 pass. The result is shown by the black dashed line. And also, they compare with other observational works, for example, using different traces, for example, Papastaris 2011. Using H1 alfalfa survey, represented here by the dashed red line, and also compared with, for example, Gonzalez 2000, who used the Suders sky redshift survey that used the luminosity function and the Tully-Fisher relation to construct, to build the velocity function, represented here by the orange line. Then the final goal of this project is try to build the velocity function using MANGA galaxies. So some years ago, the observations were made using long slit spectroscopy. However, the information could be biased due to projection effects or several assumptions, or for example, symmetry. But as Mariana told us yesterday, with the integral field spectroscopy, we have a different advantage. For example, we can resolve spatially the properties of galaxies. For the kinematics, it's very important because now we can explore if the kinematics is perturbed or galaxies are not in equilibrium. So in this project, we are using the final data release of Khalifa survey, 667 galaxies, and also we are using the MANGA sample. As a background, in my Pulisic paper, Aquino Ortiz 2018, we explore kinematic scaling relations using Khalifa galaxies, more or less 300 Khalifa galaxies. We explore these scaling relations using integrated kinematics at one effective radius, and also spatially resolved kinematics. The motivation of this paper was by the fact of the internal kinematics of galaxies is more complex than only rotation in spiral galaxies or only velocity dispersion in elliptical galaxies. We know that elliptical galaxies have a fractional rotation, or spiral galaxies have also random motions. Then the final goal of this paper was try to unify all type of galaxies in a single scalar relation. We use the kinematic parameters introduced by Wiener and collaborators in 2006, defined by this equation, that practically is the contribution of order motions given by the rotation velocity, and also the contribution of disorder motions given by the velocity dispersion. Here, k is a constant, generally assumed equal to 0.5. This kinematic parameter has been used by different other works. And in this plot, I show you the results. The color code represent different morphologies. In the left panel, you can see the total stellar mass versus the rotation velocity at one effective radius. And as expected, the scatter is dominated by early type galaxies. The panel in the mirror, you can see the total stellar mass versus the central velocity dispersion. And as you can see, early type galaxies follow the Faber-Jackson relation, and the scatter is dominated by late-type galaxies. However, when we use the total velocity parameter, all galaxies, spiral and ellipticals, follow the same scaling relation, and this scaling relation is tighter compared with the velocity dispersion and compared with the rotation at one effective radius. We suppose that this total velocity parameter is a better proxy of the gravitational potential Then we define the dynamical mass enclosed at one characteristic radius in terms of this total velocity parameter with a correction factor eta. This eta and also this k value could be different for each galaxy and could be a strong function of the formation history of galaxies. So we calibrate this equation using Schwarzschild and Young's dynamical models by Xu and collaborators 2018. And we found that we can recover robustly the dynamical masses with the eta coefficient equal to 1.8 if we suppose that this characteristic radius is equal to the effective radius. In this plot, I show you the results. In the y-axis, you can see the dynamical masses estimated with this calibrated equation. And in the x-axis, you can see the dynamical masses estimated with Schwarzschild and Young's dynamical models. And basically, we recovered the one-to-one relation with the scatter equal to 0.15. Actually, this equation is similar to the James Bullock showed in his talk. And this value is similar also. He showed that this value is equal to 2. And we find that this parameter is equal to 1.8. So now in this plot, I show you the distribution of dynamical masses at one effective radius versus the stellar mass also at one effective radius. And we are comparing with the semi-empirical modeling by Rodriguez Puebla and collaborators, represented here by the blue dashed line and the blue region. And here we want to show two important results. First is that with the color code symbols, we are in agreement with the semi-empirical modeling. And the second important result is that galaxies at low stellar masses at one effective radius and also galaxies at high stellar masses at one effective radius appear to be more dark matter dominated than galaxies with intermediate stellar masses. Now here we have a calibrated equation to estimate the dynamical masses given the total velocity parameter at one effective radius. Then we estimate the total velocity parameter in the manga sample, more or less 3,000 galaxies, and apply the calibrated equation. And in this plot, I show you the results. In the y-axis, you can see the total the dynamical mass at one effective radius versus the baryonic mass, also one effective radius. Here, the magenta line is the prediction of semi-empirical modeling by Rodriguez Puebla. And the color code represent different morphologies. Basically, we're in agreement with the results using Khalifa galaxies, and we are in agreement also with the semi-empirical modeling. Other important result is that galaxies with low baryonic mass at one effective radius and galaxies with high baryonic mass at one effective radius appear to be more dark matter dominated than galaxies with intermediate baryonic mass at one effective radius. So in order to quantify the result in these two plots, I show you the dark matter fraction estimated by this equation in the top panel for late type galaxies. In the y-axis, you can see the dark matter fraction at one effective radius versus the total stellar mass. The gray symbols are my results. The blue line and the blue shaded region are the median and the 20 and 80 percentile in mass beams. Here we are comparing with other observational results by Tortora 2019 using the SPARC database, represented here by the green line. And also we are comparing with some empirical modeling with adiabatic contraction, represented here by the magenta dashed line, and also without adiabatic contraction, represented here by the dotted magenta line. And also we are comparing with cosmological simulation by Lely 2019, from Illustris TNG, represented here by the dotted cyan line. And in the bottom panel, you can see in the y-axis the dark matter fraction at one effective radius versus the total stellar mass for elite-type galaxies. Again, my results are represented here by the gray symbols and the red line and red dashed shaded region are the median and the 20 and 90 percentile in mass beams. Also, we are comparing with other observational results. For example, the green squares are for Capillary 2013 using Atlas 3D survey. And also, we are comparing with Bernabe 2011 using lensing. The orange symbols are using Chabrier IMF, and the yellow symbols are using Salpeter IMF. Also, we are comparing with the with cosmological simulation by Illustris TNG, represented here by the cyan dotted line. Basically, we are in agreement with other observational results. We are in agreement with semi-empirical modeling, and also we are in agreement with cosmological simulation, for example, Illustris TNG. All the results here are integrated at one effective radius, but as I said before, we also explore scaling relations using spatially resolved kinematics. For a golden sample of more or less 1,000 galaxies of Kalifa surveys, we estimate the rotation curve, and in that rotation curve, we estimate the maximum velocity. And in this plot, I show you the Tolly feature relation using the Bmax, and we compare with Avila-Ries 2008 Tolly feature relation, and basically we are in agreement with Avila-Ries 2008. So for a sample or more or less 1,000 galaxies, we have estimation of the rotation velocity at one effective radius, and also we have estimation for the same sample, the Bmax. Then we apply an analytical functional form calibrated with subsamples in order to try to extrapolate from Vrot at one effective radius to Bmax. Actually, this is a work in progress, but preliminary results you can see in this plot. The cyan symbols, the left panel is for gas kinematics and the right panel is for stellar kinematics. The cyan symbols and the yellow symbols are the relationship between the rotation velocity at one effective radius versus Bmax. As expected, Bmax is larger than the velocity at one effective radius. After applying this analytical functional form to the data, we recover the one-to-one relation represented here by the blue and red symbols. That is the relation between the extrapolation velocity and Bmax. Then, so far, we have an analytical form in order to extrapolate the rotation velocity at one effective radius to Bmax. Now, as my goal of this project is try to construct the velocity function using manga galaxies. In this plot, I show you in blue symbols the velocity function using the rotation velocity at one effective radius. As expected, we are underestimated the velocity function. We use the volume correction by Caleta Morin that is in the audience. But after apply the extrapolation to go from B rot at one effective radius to Bmax, we obtain these red symbols, and practically we're in agreement with Kalifa and Kalifa plus H1, and also we're in agreement with Papastaris 2011 who use H1 alfalfa survey. We're in agreement between 100 kilometers by second until 300 kilometers by second. At high velocities, there are discrepancies. So this extrapolation could be more or less tricky. Then, as alternative, we are applying machine learning regression techniques. But to be honest, I'm not expert in this topic. Actually, it's my first time speaking about machine learning, but my collaborator Arturo Treyes is working on that. So here, basically, I will introduce only the basic idea. We are using machine learning techniques in order to training a sample of data. Actually, we have 200 manga galaxies well resolved. I mean, we have the Bmax of 200 galaxies with manga. We use 160 for training and 40 for testing, and apply random forest algorithms. The final goal is once trained this algorithm, we can apply it to many manga galaxies. And my last slide is a really preliminary result using machine learning techniques and artificial neural networks. Here we are exploring which parameters are more important to predict the maximum velocity. And here, in these two plots, I show you the Tolly feature relation, in blue, the training sample, and in red, the testing sample. Basically, we are more or less predicting the maximum velocity, but this work is in progress, and these are preliminary results. And this is my summary. That's it. Thank you.
Any questions? Yes.
So you find a much higher dark matter fraction for early types than capillary, and that's because of the different choice in IMF,
yeah,
correct? Now, the stellar profile has a very different slope than the dark matter profile, so in principle, you can distinguish that in a dynamical model. Do you understand what I mean? Did you try that?
Actually, we are working on that. Okay. We will construct dynamical models in order to test the slope of the...
Okay. Now, if the IMF has a radius dependence, then I don't know what to do anymore, but...
Okay.
Okay. Any other questions? Okay. Let's thank Eric one more time.